Good Friday morning. It is 5 o'clock. Thanks for counting on NBC 2 News today. We made it to the end of another work week. Looking forward to the weekend. Hopefully the weather's going to be nice. Good morning, everyone. I'm Alan Campbell.
I'm Joshua Cole. I think you are a little too hopeful there.
Maybe.
I know. Let's get over to NBC 2 First Alert meteorologist Jason Dunning. Jason, I know we're watching a whole lot right now from our tropics to locally with just rainy season. What can we expect?
Yeah, well, today we're going to have some areas of rain and storms as well as the weekend, but I want to start off with the tropics here at 5 a.m. as we often like to do. And first show you the big picture. We've got three tropical waves now on the board, no active storms, but this one right here in the middle is what we call Invest 95L, basically just means an area to investigate. You'll notice those odds shooting up from the last couple days, even just 24 hours ago. And now the two-day odds at 80% of tropical development, seven-day odds up to 90%. So we're fairly confident this is gonna spin up into a tropical system. Likely a tropical storm. Beryl would be the next name on the list. It's currently just under 3,000 miles away from the U.S. mainland, so we have a lot of time to watch it. Typically, you would not expect to see tropical development this far out in the Atlantic here in, well, the first month of the hurricane season, but water temperatures plenty warm, and there's actually not a whole lot of wind shear. What we're looking at now is your tropics future cast. This is the American forecast model, and if you look closely here, you can see those winds kind of tightening up, and that means we'll likely have a close circulation, a storm moving toward the western Atlantic and the eastern Caribbean. This is the Lesser Antilles. Notice the time here. This is around 5 o'clock on Monday is when it starts to move into the eastern Caribbean, and one of the questions is what kind of wind shear, what kind of environment we'll be moving into. Some models actually want to weaken it as it pushes westward. Others want to strengthen it. And the strength of it will depend on where it's ultimately going to end up going. So we have a lot of time to watch it. If it did have, again, if, big if, it did have an impact on the U.S., it would not be until next weekend. All right, so as we go to the NBC2 First Alert live Doppler radar right now, we've got some rain, some active weather here across Punta Gorda and Charlotte County, basically right along Marion Avenue now down through Fisherman's Village and up the Peace River. And these areas of rain pretty heavy and it's not really moving a whole lot. We'll see some more areas of rain as we go through the morning hours. By the afternoon, though, most of the storms will be pushing east of I-75, so our rain chances around 40% today, up to about 70 to 80%. Saturday and Sunday, most of that rain comes in the afternoon. We'll talk more about the tropics coming up, and I've got some new spaghetti plots to show you to give you an idea of exactly where the system could end up over the next 7 days. That's coming up in your First Alert forecast in about 10 minutes.